Salut tout le monde, c'est Vince et aujourd'hui on se retrouve sur Code QG pour une nouvelle et rapide vidéo. Une vidéo parce que Treyarch nous a montré les coulisses de la création de Nuketown, la map iconique de la série Black Ops. Je vous en parle tout de suite. Juste avant que la vidéo commence, je tenais à vous informer encore une fois que nous avons lancé notre concours de Noël en partenariat avec Instant Gaming. Le lien est en description, vous pouvez gagner ce que vous voulez. Ça peut être une carte Xbox Live, une carte PSN, un jeu de votre choix, bref, tout ce que vous voulez. Le lien est en description, n'hésitez pas à participer. Et je vous mets également un deuxième lien si vous voulez gagner un casque en partenariat avec SteelSeries FR. Le lien est également en description, bref. Ça, c'est dit, c'est fait. Maintenant, on passe au sujet de la vidéo. C'est la série intitulée Declassified, qui veut dire déclassifié, qui est donc une nouvelle série de vidéos publiées sur la chaîne de Treyarch pour nous montrer un peu les coulisses, l'histoire, le making-of de la série Call of Duty et plus particulièrement, il y a de fortes chances que ça soit pour la série Black Ops. Et ce premier épisode concerne la map Nuketown qui est de retour sur Blackout, le mode Battle Royale de Black Ops 4. Ça, je pense que je ne vous apprends rien. Mais ce qui est intéressant, c'est comment est-ce que cette carte a été créée. Et ben, c'est Adam Ogat qui est concepteur de niveau chez Treyarch et qui est donc a été le créateur de Nuketown qui nous a expliqué comment cette carte a été créée. David Von der Haar avait envoyé un courrier électronique dans lequel il était écrit « Hey, et si on faisait une petite carte à partir d'une ville d'essai nucléaire ?» Et notre ami Adam Ogat a immédiatement eu des idées en tête. Il a donc créé la map Nuketown, ou plus précisément une première ébauche, on va dire, à cette carte qu'il a envoyée directement. Et tout de suite, les équipes de Treyarch et David Von der Haar ont adoré et ont su percevoir le potentiel de cette map. Et c'est ainsi que Nuketown a été créé, que Nuketown a été ajouté à Black Ops. Je vous laisse la vidéo en entier si jamais ça vous intéresse. C'était Vince, salut tout le monde et à la prochaine, bye bye.
Typically, we will develop kind of the general idea that we want the whole map to be. What we try to do is focus on the hook of the map and what makes the map unique. And we start that process on paper. And then when we get into the editor in 3D, we'll build out a section of that map. New ideas and new things just kind of happen as you're building that.
Every little thing, even when we're detailing, serves a purpose from cover, which serves the gameplay and lines of sight, but also it tells you where to go. So as a player and I'm navigating and flowing around the map, you kind of want to naturally go to where there's cover because you want to be protected. That's also going to tell you you're probably going to get in a fight, so I should get ready.
So I had just finished working on the map Radiation from Black Ops 1, and an email came out from Vaughn saying, hey, you know, what if we make a small map based on these nuclear testing towns, these fake towns that they used to set up when they'd test nukes and they destroy them. And I just like, I started getting ideas in my head instantly. And I didn't want to just take the idea of a small map where you just throw everyone together and just let them go at it in a chaotic sort of way. I wanted to keep all the elements that we normally would put in any other map.
Nuketown is interesting because Adam came in and was like, hey, I made this map. We're like, we didn't ask you to make that map. Why are you making that map? But he brought it in, and it was really interesting because he was really inspired by this sort of super frenetic gameplay. Nuketown kind of really opened our eyes about this sort of really frenetic head-on engagements, but it has a lot of complexity. And then from there, we're like, we have to ship this. And everyone was like, this has to go for the game, no matter what. And everyone kind of rallied, and we made it happen.
We did think about, you know, what other things do we want to do? You know, what if we had another path? And we, at one point, we tried having a flank path around behind where the pink house is through the yard. And we just thought, hey, you know what? What happens if we try this? So we tried it and it was terrible. So that got taken out right away. And it actually didn't change too much throughout the development. We didn't have the bus and the moving van. It was more, you know, an open center, which was even more dangerous. And so that's where the bus and the moving van came in. When we did the updated versions for Black Ops 2, we didn't want to make a different map. We wanted to keep it Nuketown. We wanted it to still feel like Nuketown. So we didn't change too much. Black Ops 3 was a different story. We obviously had all new movement mechanics. We had the thrust jumping and wall running. And so in the end, we just stuck with allowing you to use the new core movement mechanics, but let's still keep it Nuketown.
Coming from Black Ops 3, we wanted to do something really different. How do you do that for Nuketown, which still needs to be, you know, retain the Nuketown magic, which is campy and kind of fun in some meaningful way? When we were building it, one thing that we went too far is we made it too real and depressing. And we started to look at it and we're like, this is bumming me out. Like, this is not Nuketown, because Nuketown is bright colors and fun. And so we were kind of at odds on maintaining the Nuketown fun, but bringing this sort of new Russian snowy, realish world gritty component together. One of the ideas was like the doors would open and stay open during gameplay, which would totally drastically change Nuketown. And we were like, that's too extreme. The other big thing we wanted to do was Nuketown's always been what you see is what you get, right? From the first one, right, to BO2 to BO3, is you knew exactly what you were looking at. We wanted to kind of flip that up so you thought you knew what you were looking at, but it's actually, there's more hidden there that you've never seen before. And that's where this idea, we were kind of joking, it was just like, oh, it'd be funny if we did like the Russian nuclear test site. And it actually started as that idea, like the Russian town, right? What would that look like if they were also testing the bomb? But there's this underbelly of this nuclear launch facility. Seen through all the iterations and kind of the learnings from each of the Nuketowns has been really interesting, because it has to maintain that feel of Nuketown, which is not easy to do, because it plays different than any other map we've ever done before, and players will know if you've tweaked something. So we're super hypersensitive to maintaining the Nuketown feel and vibe, but delivering it in some new way, and that's always the challenge, which is really cool.